Okay, so we're gonna do lunging here with Buddy as a response to Lester and Jamie on lunging 101. And Buddy has volunteered to do this. So I might need to move that down a little bit as I'm looking at it up close, because I won't be able to see it once I get away, and hopefully you can hear me. Buddy's already messed up the program. Hey, Corn Chip, come on over here. So I'm in the middle now. I don't know if you can see Buddy. So we're gonna do it right out here. And the wind is blowing pretty bad out here, so I've got you behind a barn. So hopefully we're in the picture here, and you can tell this is lunging Lester style, and the horse doesn't, oh, actually my horse does listen, maybe not. So he's like, this is Lester lunging, Ray Charles school of lunging. So look, lunging has to be a communication between you and your horse. He's not communicating because I'm not communicating. He's eating and ignoring me because I'm not telling him that's the wrong answer. He's moving to the end of the rope because I'm not telling him to pay attention to me. So I have to have some sort of connection so he knows we're working and not just leading and I'm letting him eat. So I'm gonna give him a little guidance and get him in here. Hey, hey, my voice will change. Hey, Buddy. And of course, we have the mare screaming and hollering, messing all this up. So this is going to affect his ability to pay attention to me, so I may have to get a little bit more aggressive. Mr. T is over here, out of sight, because I gave him some hay while I got Buddy out here. So let me, Buddy's ignoring me, and he's trying to say, I want to ignore you. He's got his butt to me. He's not listening to me because I'm not talking to him. I'm talking to you. So let's try to get him in lunging mode. I'm going to be clear. I'm going to be direct. And I'm going to be talking to him, not to the camera, not to anything else. So he's eating his new hay. I'm going to get him to come back here to me by just giving him a little pressure on his head and not letting loose. And he's going to say, okay, Dad wants me. So I have him come in on me, and I'm going to stop him. He knows to stop because I gave him direction by stopping. I don't want to lunge a horse by doing this and pulling, because that's not lunging. I want to use my body to make him go and give him direction to stop. Remember the drive line. I'm going to watch this shoulder. I'm going to have I'm going to run a rope through his leg here. I'm going to have an imaginary laser going to this shoulder, and I'm going to be behind it. If I'm here, I'm in front of the drive line. If I'm here, I'm behind the drive line. You have to keep that imaginary thing on the drive line. And that little mare is just really messing up the program, because she's going to keep calling and he's going to want to answer. Okay, so let's get him in a lunging mode here. Hey, Corn Chip, you ready? Come on, let's do some lunging. I know. So he knows I'm talking to him. So first, if he's this way, I can either change my direction and make him go this way, or he's got an itch. I'm going to beat him like Redheaded Stitcher. Are you done? My goodness, Buddy. That's it. So if I wanted to teach him to do that, I would keep releasing pressure and give him a treat, and I could teach him to push me. But I don't want to do that. He had an itch, so I don't know why. Probably this thing is really high. I'm using Mr. T's halter, and it's really high on him. And it's not normally that high. All right, so we're going to lunge now. You ready? Hey, I'm really going to start. Okay, direction, really clear direction, nothing with this hand unless I want him to move. This hand will only move when I want movement. This hand will be direction. When I switch directions, it's very easy to switch. I reach over, now I have new direction, and I have new movement. If I want to change directions, I reach over, I have new direction and new movement. So you have to learn how to work your rope easily instead of with a whip and with all this. Okay, so let's get him moving. Hey. Direction. And he came to me. That's the wrong answer. Movement. Movement. Direction. Direction. He wants to stop. I'm going to beat him like a redheaded stepchild. So I'm going to probably have to get a little aggressive here because we haven't done this in a while. Again, I'm pointing, he's moving, I'm not giving any pressure. He's doing what I want. I'm just staying behind this drive line. Behind the drive line. Pressure, he wanted to stop. Pressure, he wanted to stop. Pressure, he's not moving fast enough. You're gonna... Now he's looking like voodoo. I swear, I'm trying to teach you how to slow control this mare's got him on track. Dad still loves you. Alright, so he's got to get some piss and vinegar out of him. So I'm going to stop talking and just work him. Direction, and I gave it to him. I'm just going to talk. See, every time I talk to you, he thinks I'm talking. It's okay, I know. I want you to watch. I'm not going to talk to you guys. When I change directions, all I do is I kind of give him, some people call it a tap. I don't like tapping him. I'm going to give him a little pressure on his nose to make sure he's looking at me, and then I'm going to distinctly move in front of his drive line and switch hands. It's going to happen very fluidly and quickly. So it's going to happen quick. He's going to be going one way. I'm going to change my eye to look at his butt to make it move away. I'm going to make his head come in. I'm going to switch hands, move, and change his direction. It'll happen like that, but there's a lot going on. Ready? Come on. I know. It's okay. You can walk. Pressure, 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 more pressure, more pressure, more pressure. Good boy, I know. Good boy. You're gonna be in big trouble. So we're gonna change directions quite a few times here. Gotta walk. Now we're paying attention. And I'm going to look at the butt, and he will tow that butt away from me. He's like, dude, what did I do to deserve this? It's okay, buddy. I'm telling you, this is probably the first time either he got in trouble when I was shooing him and I lunged him, or I haven't lunged him in probably 2 to 3 years. I just don't do it. But he still knows he has to listen to me. I know I'm doing it right, giving him clear direction. And you can tell when I change directions, that step and changing direction is critical, and the change of focus. When he's going forward, I'm looking here. When I step in front of him, I'm looking here. And you may not be able to see that, but that makes a difference. So forward, 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 stop or change direction. So when you see me switch hands, he's going this way. I'm giving him pressure, 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 pressure. I move away, I look at his butt, I change hands, and now he gets new pressure. And that's why a couple times when I was doing it quickly, you saw him jumping on his rear end and saying, I know I need to change direction. He was anticipating, knowing that's what he's gonna have to do. I know. Come on, let's do it again. Good boy. So you see my feet moving. What I saw Jamie and Lester doing a lot, they were standing here and trying to do this. And their feet were planted in a circle. And you really can't control that drive line. If I'm looking at the drive line, I gotta get in front of it or behind it. I'm lunging forward. When I want them to stop or change directions, I move in front of it. So if there's a straight line with my hand and this is the drive line on the horse, when I'm pushing him this way, I'm behind it. When I want to stop his forward movement or change directions, I've got to move in front of the hand, in front of the drive line, and then I give him his new direction. So hopefully you saw that. So again, I don't do this a whole bunch. So, Buddy's probably going to go roam back over to Mr. T, which I'm okay with. He's going to eat. His girlfriend's calling him. Hopefully you can hear me. I'll go ahead and turn this around so we can watch Buddy and the horses. So he's going to eat. He worked up a little sweat. That's the most work that horse has had, and I don't know how damn long. And that's why he was so full of himself, and that's why he was jumping, and you saw that energy. He's like, why are you doing this? What? And I kind of had to turn up the heat, and I kind of had to get on him. If you notice, I picked up my body energy. My whole energy changed when I was putting pressure on him. I wasn't standing flat-footed and just moving a whip or moving a rope. My whole body engaged in more pressure and in less pressure. And moving in front of the drive line was very distinct. As you get good, you can do it much easier and slighter, and you won't even know it. So, that little mare is just all, anytime she can't see Mr. T, she just has a fit. She's cute. I give them a little hay at night and so they can eat and they can fence each other. So, there's old Mr. T eating his hay. And see, I put a flake out there and he's been eating all this time and it's still there. He eats so slow. Buddy would have all that gone. I put that pile there. And where's the other pile? There's another pile somewhere out there. Is that it? I can't tell. So there's one pile. And if I follow the line down, there's the other pile right there. So, and again, he's trying to eat that. So I'm gonna leave Buddy out here. He's gonna nibble on all this and he'll roam outside because he'll hang by Mr. T. And then I'll go upload this video and we'll go from there. But hopefully you got some out of there. Hopefully I was in camera and I showed you were able to see the maneuver. I couldn't really see my camera screen because of the sun. This was in the shade. I was in the sun. But hopefully you get the gist. All right. Buddy, you're a good boy. Even though Dad had to get on you and you tried to kick Dad because you're a big mean horsey. He wasn't trying to kick me. He was bucking and showing a protest. And he was trying to show his strength. Just kind of like Voodoo did a little bit in their video. All right. We'll end that there.